Hello everybody, welcome to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So today our topic is capacitor reactor sizing or detuned filter. Okay, so in one of my very previous video, one of my very early video, I explained that how power factor improvement capacitors are sized and how we can improve particular power factor to a certain value to another required value by using capacitor bank. I am giving link in the I button. You can check that video. Now this video is basically continuation of that video. Okay, so in this video we will see that how the capacitor reactor are sizing and why the reactor is used. In my previous video, the video I am referring, I used mentioned only about capacitor, but in this video we will know that only capacitor is not sufficient, another inductor is also to be introduced. So let's begin the video. Purpose of capacitor and inductor with it. Now we know that capacitor is generally used for power factor improvement. However, at the time of switching on the capacitor acts as short circuit and it draws huge current. See, capacitor opposes sudden change of voltage. So whenever you switch on a capacitor, it basically acts that it has no internal voltage and it acts like short circuit, draws huge current to get charged, and gradually the voltage builds up inside it and the current reduced. But this huge amount of starting current, the initial current, may damage the capacitor. For that reason, an inductor is introduced in series with the capacitor to limit the current, because we know that inductor opposes sudden change of current, right? Okay. So another interesting thing is that this kind of arrangement, a capacitor in series with a reactor, acts as an LC filter of harmonics. Okay. Because in industry, various semiconductor drives are used, like battery charger, UPS, VFD, soft starter. Okay. This device generates harmonics. So this capacitor inductor bank also filter out those harmonics. Now we will see that how the inductor is specified. See, the inductor is specified as 4% to 7% series reactor or detuned filter. That means whenever you have to specify a capacitor bank with an inductor, you have to write that we need such and such amount of kevlar with 7% or 4% inductor, right? Okay, now what does that mean? It means that impedance of the reactor is 7% of impedance of the capacitor. Now in this video we will further see how those values are calculated. Okay, so this is the diagram. Suppose this is the 6.6 kV bus and this is the capacitor. So an inductor will be connected in series with the capacitor. Now in my previous video, in my early video, I mentioned that how the kVAr rating is calculated. So suppose you have got 750 kVAr at 6.6 kV. That means this capacitor inductor bank, the whole setup will give you 750 kVAr, not the capacitor itself. Okay, the entire setup will give you 750 kVAr, and the voltage across this terminal will be 6.6 kV. So whatever the voltage is here, we have to find out whether it is 6.6 kV or higher or lower. We have to find that out, right? Because there will be also a voltage drop due to this inductor. So we have to take care of that. Now we will see the calculations. Now where XEQ, in this video the following terminologies will be used. XEQ will stand for equivalent impedance of the LC bank. XL and L will stands for impedance or reactance of the inductor and its value in Henry. XC and C will stands for impedance of the capacitor and its capacitance. VL means voltage drop across the inductor. VC means voltage of the capacitor. And kVAr C means kVAr of the capacitor only. This is excluded the reactor, right? This is the kVAr. This kVAr is not the kVAr of the entire bank. The bank kVAr is 750 kVAr, but this is only the kVAr of the capacitor itself. Okay. That means we have to find that what is impedance of this capacitor, what is impedance of this inductor, what is voltage drop across this inductor, and what is this voltage and this kVAr, right? So let's see one after another. Now we know that X equivalent will be kV square by mVAr, right? We know that impedance is equal to kV square by mVA. So from that we can calculate that X eq is equal to 58.08 ohm per phase. Okay. Now we are designing the system with 7% reactor. So XL, this XL will be 7% of XC. See, meaning of the 7% reactor, whenever you are said that 7% reactor for capacitor banks, you will take it like this. 7% means the value of XL will be 7% of XC. Okay. So what will be X equivalent? X equivalent will be XC minus XL. So 0.93 XC, which is basically equal to 58.08. So now we can find out that XC is equal to 62.45 ohm per phase. So for 50 Hertz system, capacitance will be, you can check it, it will be 51 microfarad, right? So this capacitance will be 51 microfarad. Now XL is equal to 0.07 XC, so XL is equal to 4.37 ohm per phase by multiplying this factor XC with 0.07. This is 4.37 ohm per phase. So L will be XL by 2 pi f for 50 Hertz system, it will be 13.9 millihenry. Okay. Now capacitor bank current, what is the current of the capacitor bank? It will be 750 kVAr by 1.732 by 6.6, that is 65.61 ampere. So voltage drop across this inductor will be root 3 into I into XL, that is 496.59 volt. So this voltage will be this 6.6 kV plus this drop, but this 6.6 kV we have to take a margin of 10%. Okay. So see here, the capacitor voltage is considered as 6600 into 1.1. We will take 10% margin on that. This is as per Indian standard recommendation. Plus this voltage drop. Voltage drop due to this XL. So capacitor voltage, you can see that it is far higher than 6.6 kV. It is basically 7.7 kV. Right. So this is generating 7.7 kV and due to this voltage drop, the terminal voltage will be around 6.6 kV. Okay. So what will be our consolidated design? Now only capacitor kVAr we have to find out. It will be 7.7 into 7.7 into 1000 by 62.45. Let me explain. We know that XC will be is equal to kV square by mVAr. So mVAr will be is equal to kV square by XC. Now if we represent it in kVAr, it will be kV square into 1000 by XC, right? So this is kV into 1000 by XC. So this is the kVAr. So that means this capacitor will have a kVAr of 950, not 750. For 750 kVAr, you have to select the capacitor of 950. Okay. So what is the summary of the design? That is, value of this inductance is 13.9 millihenry. Capacitance is 51 microfarad, 950 kVAr and 7.7 kV. So this will be the design for 750 kVAr, 6.6 kV capacitor bank with 7% inductor. Okay. So this is how the capacitor bank is sized. Now, so whenever you have to calculate the capacitor bank, first you have to check that from which power factor to which power factor you have to improve. By this you will be able to find out the kVAr rating of the entire capacitor reactor bank, then you have to select individual rating by this formula. Okay. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Thank you very much for watching this video.